I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Romo's Cowboys going up against McCarron's 49ers. With that, let's get out west to Santa Clara, where we say hello to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we are down the peninsula from San Francisco as you get a look inside modern Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Dallas Cowboys and the San Francisco 49ers. And the kick goes outside the white lines. That's why the flag comes out.
Yes, and that was an error by the kicker, and it will give the offense great starting field position.
That time and a new set of downs. So good for the Buckeyes last year, and he's taken that from the college game, showing some glimpses of it here in the NFL.
How about his last season with Ohio State? Over 1,800 yards, only one game where he didn't get over 100. Remember, he demanded the ball from then on out. I think they listened to him, and they were smart to do so.
And now they're giving it to him here on the next level. They go play action here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Okay, starting lineup time offensively, Charles, for the Dallas Cowboys.
And how about them at number four in the 2016 draft? Big needs on the defensive line. And they go with the running
back. They go star power.
They went star power, but Ezekiel Elliott, in a lot of ways, was exactly the right decision. When they had winning success in 2014, they did it running the football. Elliott can do that for them again.
Back to the air they go. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Eli Harold. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
First carry for Carlos Hyde. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
The tight end changing his position. On second down, Hyde. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll lead here to a third down.
So often you hear defensive coaches talk about we need all 11 on every play in order to be a good run-stopping unit. And sometimes it starts to sound a little cliche, but did you see the free safety on that play? Knifing through and running down the ball carrier. A huge, huge play. And when you have a free safety who can run like that, you've got to turn him loose.
To throw McCarron. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game, I'm going to show them this play because they couldn't get to the passer. So what do you have to do? Get your hands up in the passing lane, and they batted it away on a third down attempt.
On is Nick Novak now to try the field goal. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead.
So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit, taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
Now after the made field goal, here's Dawson back out now to send this one away on the kickoff. And this kick goes out of bounds, and that's obviously why the flag comes out here.
And now you can see the defense greeting the kicker as they go out to play. The starting field position for the offense is excellent, puts a lot more pressure on the defensive guys.
Yeah, and if the kicker thinks he's lonesome, he's really lonesome after a play like this.
Hey, he better hope that he's lonesome, because whoever's standing next to him is probably on the defensive side, and they're none too happy.
Over, over. Bryant, the man in motion right. Romo hands to Allian. And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And they're definitely showing blitz here. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Second down, Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. From the gun on third down, Romo. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And the coach has decided to challenge this play. He has tossed down the red flag. Kicks away as he angles this one for the sideline. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Jalen Smith out of Notre Dame. Partner, that's got to be one of the best stories in the NFL, seeing him out on the field.
Yeah, it really is. That injury that he had during the bowl game against Ohio State, boy, that hurt his draft stock. So nice to see him out there.
I had him rated as the top player in his class in 2016 before his injury. He ends up,
and that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, 49ers. Torrey Smith, an 80-yard touchdown. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for six. That was a nice little setup there off play action for the long touchdown pass.
Yeah, I've got to tell you, it brings back bad memories for a guy like me as a former defensive back, because in a playbook I knew a long time ago, we described that play pattern as draw pass 9 go, meaning fly pattern after the play action pass, trying to hit him for the deep ball. And boy, were they successful on that one. So tough because his speed is so great. You've got to make sure you don't miss any cues or keys in order to try and keep up with him.
Draw pass, nine go. That's still a nightmare to this day.
Yeah, I still wake up in the middle of the night and feel the guy going past me.
Here's Elliott, and he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and six. And the 49ers on the defensive side of the football.
Eric Reed is a safety that you can use all over on defense, both in the box as a tackler and back deep as a cover man.
Second down. Going to throw right side here. Complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And the offense lining up first and 10. On first down, Romo. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
They'll come out in the pistol. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a first down throw, Romo. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. It'll be a gain of six, and it'll make it second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Another pistol look here. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a third and four.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
And now it's a third and four situation for the offense. The Cowboys' all-time receptions leader, Jason Witten, the intended target. And it brings up fourth down. And the Cowboys will call on Dan Bailey here. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. But there is a penalty marker down. They might be forced to try this one again. And here comes play number six on this drive.
Get ready.
First and goal here from the nine. After the penalty, it's Elliott. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Give him three on the gain there. Second and goal. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. And he motions the wide receiver.
Kill, kill, kill.
They'll try try again with Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let him run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They start the drive with Hyde. Uses the stiff arm. And he's brought down. 12 yards on the pickup. And it'll be first down 49ers.
There's no doubt that his size is a factor, but I've seen a lot of big running backs in the league not have that kind of impact because they don't run like a big back should. Get behind their pads, as they like to say, lower center of gravity, and knock people backwards. Sometimes they run too upright and take too many hits. Not this guy. He knows how to get low, break tackles, and gain additional yardage. As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Second down now after the incompletion.
Lock at 56. Lock at 56.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now Hyde running right. And he'll get this up to about the 40. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And the offense in that middle ground here on third down, third and five. McCarron. Complete to Gilmore, the tight end. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Strike, they'll look to throw, and he will go down. A Cowboys sack. They'll wind up losing eight on the sack there, and it's second down.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
To throw, McCarron. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third.
Over, 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 over.
they'll throw here out of the gun. And incomplete here to bring up fourth down as the rookie couldn't haul it in.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Now here's the Niners' fifth-round pick in the 2015 draft, Bradley Pinion on to punt it away. Lucky Whitehead back deep for Dallas. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he stopped immediately. Looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. To throw on second down. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. They'll set up a throw. And his throw here's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Crockett Gilmore, there. That'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now Hyde. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
Every now and then when we see a really good run, we really tend to focus on what other people did in order for that run to happen. What the offensive line did, what the receivers did to help. Sometimes the running back's pretty good, too. And on that play, he picked up a lot of good yardage.
And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back.
Watch left, tight end to the left, tight end to the left.
They come out here in the eye. He'll look to throw. That's caught at the one. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Torrey Smith, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the 49ers add on to their lead. It's good to make it 17-7. After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Tiger!
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Cole Beasley, the intended target. And now it's second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Halfback sent in motion. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. He hits Beasley right side. And he's able to get up here to the 26. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys on plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3. This is where the ball goes anymore.
12 yards on the return that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And that last touchdown drive, a good mix of pass and run. Defensively, they just looked a little out of whack.
And it's so hard to stay up with an offense that has things going so well, where you're guessing and guessing wrong play after play. So what you need is someone on the defensive side of the
leader, right?
To make a big play.
Yeah.
Throw that balance out of whack. That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is. And that one was knocked away, and I think the defenders are going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw it to him. And that was a play made by the defense, and it could have been a bigger one.
McCarron, 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Another pistol look here. Back to throw here. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Then they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Now a first down throw, Romo. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he gets this one all the way up to the 40. A good pick up there of 20. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. This one deep right side, and they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful.
Cut me out, partner. Was that incomplete?
That was on a deep ball to Dez.
And that's a surprise. The way he attacks the football in the air, it's always surprising to me when he doesn't complete a pass like that.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Just beating the play clock, Romo. Bryant with a catch right side. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
50-50. They go play action here on first down. And now for the third time, Romo intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return will be stopped. At the 34-yard line, as San Francisco gets set to go here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
All right, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
To throw McCarron. Smith catches left side. And he's brought down after a good game. Having an effective short passing game, one of their main concerns coming into this one right there, able to hit the D with a quick strike and a first down.
And you're able to put that into your game plan when you see that there's space to throw the football. A lot of defenses don't want to play press coverage or tight coverage. They'll play backed off, and sometimes those cornerbacks will bail out really fast and really get deep. And that allows you to throw the quick game underneath, and they took advantage of it.
And he gets it down to the 32. It's a gain of 5, and it'll make it a second down. Second and 5. McCarron, complete to Gilmore, over the middle, and he's brought down. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
That coach is always hard on them.
Now hang on here, timeout called by the defense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offense has it first and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This will be caught at about the three. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Aaron Burbridge, his second touchdown on the season. And the 49ers add six to their lead. Novak is on to attempt the extra point. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now Dallas gets set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
I love it. We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
They come out here in the eye. And the slot man goes in motion left. He'll look to throw. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
Offense in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on third down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
This is taken at the 10. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. Touchdown, Cowboys! Dez Bryant, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys cut into that lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Normally he's pretty reliable, usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Second down following the incompletion.
Here we go now.
The slot man in motion right. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking here for Smith downfield. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off. It's J.J. Wilcox. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. Now Dallas gets set to take the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. And that will be caught by incomplete here. And on second and 10 now.
Of all the routes that defenders would love to remove from offensive playbooks, I think the wheel route would rank near the top. And on that one, they almost had it, just wasn't able to come down in bounds.
Yeah, you see right there for the running back, it's tough as you're going toward that sideline trying to stay in bounds. He couldn't do it.
Yeah, just didn't have enough real estate, as they like to say.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. Here's Prescott. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Well, partner, I think the defensive fellow's gotten the memo, and they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot, couldn't get it.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally someone said, let's try and put a stop to it and put people on him.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. Kick 47. This one looks good as well. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those. And maximizing opportunities.
Let's go, Blue Line.
To throw McCarron. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. On play action, they'll throw. On the left side, it's McDonald. And he's brought down after a good game. 23 yards on the play.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
First down, a run with Hyde. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. And an 8.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. McCarron. And yes, complete to the tight end, McDonald. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And a third down pass falls incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target, and it's fourth down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Here's Bradley Pinion now. He's been terrific so far. And he'll take this in at the 1 yard line. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Dallas. Only needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Come on, let's go! What? Nine! Ohio! Ohio! Black Brown! Black Brown!
Now Prescott. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Bryce Butler, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
This has been a really nice day for the defense. They've made it so difficult to find open receivers because they're able to squeeze the passing lanes down. A lot of what they're doing is communicating. Receivers in one area, receivers in another area. They're almost what they call passing them off from one defender to the next, even in zone defenses, and making it very hard to find an open spot for the quarterback to deliver the ball.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Here we go! Ohio! Ohio! Let's go!
One,
nine. Ohio!
One man in the backfield, Elliott. Now a play fake here on first down. His throw incomplete.
When everything is in sync on defense, that means everyone's communicating really well, and sometimes it's nonverbal. They just know that when a receiver's in one spot, this person may have him, and he's in another spot, the next defender may have him. And they've squeezed the passing lanes down to where it's so difficult to find an open area to deliver the football. They've made it tough on them all game long.
They'll send a receiver in motion left. Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And that is incomplete. So a ways to go here on third and 10. They'll motion the tight end across the formation.
Ohio! Ohio! Black Brown! Black Brown!
Time running out here on the play clock. Here's Prescott. And that's incomplete. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. They run it again with Hyde. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
And that's how you run the football and run it successfully. Big-time chunk of yardage picked up, but why? Offensive lineman won at the point of attack. Their leverage way better than the defenders. The low man wins when you're getting underneath and trying to move people. And that's exactly what happened on that play. The offensive line moved the defensive front, created space, and the end result, a fantastic run.
Back now here in Santa Clara. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter.
Back in the net, Billy. Here we go.
Now a run with Hyde. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
To throw, McCarron over the middle to Smith. And he's brought down after a good game. A gain of 32 that time. Defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Here's Hyde. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. On the tackle, the rookie Jalen Smith.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
A second down carry for Ferguson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on 3rd and 8.
Here we go now. Green, 39. Green.
Back to throw here. And he finds McDonald. But he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Second and goal from the 7. Back to the ground. This time it's Hyde. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That will be their 3rd and final stoppage as they'll only have the 2-minute warning now remaining. Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. They come out here in the eye. Now the Notre Dame man. This is Theo Riddick. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4.
You're looking at his dimensions. He's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. So they settled for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the 4th.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But 3 does give him some breathing room and lets him build up a little cushion.
And oh, he kicked it out of bounds. That's a big penalty.
And this is where the rest of the team turns and stares at the kicker and says, you have one job, execute it.
In motion here is Witten. They'll look to throw now on first down. Out left side here to Bryant. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. Now Prescott. And that's caught by Beasley. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Clock winding down. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Here's Prescott. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll look to throw again. On the left side, he finds Beasley. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Try it here. He's back to throw. He completes it to Bryant, and he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Fourth and two. They got it. That was kind of that gray area. Is that a feel thing whether you go run or pass there offensively?
I think it's a feel thing.
And a 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They'll drop the throw, and he whips that one incomplete there. They gotta have six here. It's third and goal. Gun. They'll look to throw. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Drops it underneath. Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott unable to punch it in. And his 49er defense stands tall down near the goal line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
So bad.
I don't know about that. Super tough.
Detroit!
Hyde, the lone man in the backfield. He'll get the football here. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
And they'll get him down up past the 15. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. Motion now from the tight end.
319.
Motion. Where you at? Is that yours?
Another tote for the afternoon workhorse. It's high. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
But it was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They come up in an offset eye. They pitch it out to Hyde. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
McCarron. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it, and now 4th down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And last time they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Yeah, simple. Tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Prescott. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. So 2nd and 10 here.
Black crowd. Come on, let's go.
Here's Prescott. He's going to let it fly, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. 3rd down. 10 yards to go on 3rd.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward, back towards the receiver, and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
And quickly, they get to the line. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is caught. So it's a late touchdown, but maybe too late. Still a little time left on the clock, however. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
And the lead will shrink to 6. So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, 6-point game. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.
trying our best to make it last. Freedom running through us like an open. We're too high on being young and there's still to raise. We've got the rest of our lives for the rest of our lives. The rest of tonight for whatever feels right. We're doing it our way, just acting our age. One day we'll look back just shaking our heads. But right now we're too fast to slow down just yet. We're doing it our way.
Anymore. chances it's gonna rain. But we're in good, it won't change a thing. Yeah, we still got plans tonight. We're gonna kick it, that's a given, baby, rain and shine. Leave your Sunday best at home. Be the last time you wear what you got on. Bikini top, cut off jeans. Baby girl, you know you're looking mean. She said, how we gonna make it through tomorrow? Won't you think you got swampers on my truck phone? Ooh, it's about to get done in the dirty south. I'm about to show you what it's all about. But don't worry, it's a rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, we're still throwing down. We gonna test, light that fire. We gonna crank that country. Pass that, pass it, get Thursday. Let it rain. Well, it's about to get done. Watching that red clay turn to mud. Sling it up, slap past the doors like a new paint job on a 4x4. Girl, you're gonna have a good old time. Can't let a little bit of rain change your mind. Let your hair down, kick off your boots. A woman sing your life, let yourself cut loose. Gonna get money from head to toe. Clean it all, dipping in the swimming hole. Listen, about to get dirty in the dirty south. I'm about to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, it's a rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, we're still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that country. Pass and get Thursday. Change baptized in muddy water, let me hear you say. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. And it's about to get dirty in the dirty south. About to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, it's a rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, we're still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that cuss. Pass it, get Thursday.
Okay, whoa, we've been on the road. gonna blow your own mind. When I was back home washing them dishes, I was just wishing I could just bitch and I was gonna get it. I was on missions, I was just living. Walked in that building, we was just building, taking our time. We was just yielding, we was just chilling. Away from these haters, know they be watching like a theater. Lighting these niggas that we need later. They gon' degrade us, it won't delay us. This is what made us. We got Omega, probably roll. Probably just leave. I see you later. I salute Wager. Cop a new crib. Got some new neighbors. You get this big, they gon' want favors. They gon' want flavors. Probably broke. Hope the Lord save us. Wait from these haters. Hope the Lord save us. Wait from these snakes. Wait from these fakes. Wait, I need breaks. Wait, I need cake. How long can we wait? Come on,
you better not be the one to doubt her.
Cause we've been putting in the power. We only taking what was ours. So you better not be the one to doubt us. Cause we gon' blow your mind. We gon' blow your mind. We gon' blow your mind.
I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's the Panthers going up against the Bears. The opening kick is straight ahead, so it's time to turn it over to my colleagues, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis with the call. Gentlemen.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Today we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap between the Carolina Panthers. Panthers and the Chicago Bears.
Double time, double time.
They'll run. This is Jonathan Stewart. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Second down and 4. The throw on 2nd down is Newton. Looking for the tight end, Olsen, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. In motion is Grant.
No. Check. Patriot. Gun.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And with this offense, one guy to key in on defensively is Kevin White.
Had to battle injuries at the start of his career, but boy, he's ready to fulfill his promise. An absolute beast downfield.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue line. Gun.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
3-19.
They go play action here on first down. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bears have taken the early lead. And he puts it through. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And the Panthers coming out now. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's brought down after a good gain. A good pickup there, 22.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. First down. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Stewart is the lone setback. Here's Newton now on 2nd down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And that'll make it 3rd down. And what about this offense, Charles? Specifically, what about Jonathan Stewart?
He makes sure everything goes. Put the ball in his chest and watch him run. Can run with power inside, but has enough speed that when he gets outside, he can cause a lot of trouble.
And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on third and nine. Throwing on third down, Newton gets it to Benjamin. It's caught, and he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Play fake here on first down. Over the middle here to Brown. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Corey Brown. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Mario Addison, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Looks for White, but it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in the touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And here are the Chicago defensive starters.
Kyle Fuller is one of those new breed complete defensive backs. Eager to tackle, but a better cover man.
Second and 10, Newton again. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Oh, and the defender took some liberties there with a late hit, roughing the passer.
The league has done a great job of defining what is a late hit and illegal contact on a quarterback. The defenders really have to get in line.
Now a first down throw for Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. If you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Just beating the play clock is Newton. Looking for the tight end, Olsen, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They go back to the air here after the INT. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 13 yards there on the pickup, and the Bears are going to get a first.
And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And the starting defense here for the Panthers.
When Shaq Thompson declared for the draft, I said he should be a running back in the NFL. He said no way, he'd rather hit people as a linebacker.
Back to throw now on second and 10. It's brought in by Kevin White. A good pickup there of 20 yards. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders, is exactly what happened on that play.
They'll look to throw now on first down. On the left side, a catch by White. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to get this one down to about the 40. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
They'll look to throw here, and it's incomplete. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. And some room to roam now. Down the numbers. There he goes. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Partner, when it's a goal-to-go situation, if you're on the field on defense, you have to know that you may be called on to make a tackle at any time. Here, the cornerback does exactly that. Plays the run really well and makes a big play.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. The throw on second down is Newton. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. Now the Panthers get set, third and goal.
And the defense has to account for Cam Newton on this play. Come on, Baker.
They come out here in the eye. Now Newton on third and goal. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Kelvin Benjamin, his fifth touchdown now on.